Hi, I'm Johnny. Today we've got a phase one dumbbell workout, but first I have a 6-exercise warm-up that we're going to go through. It's just a general warm-up that's going to prepare the entire body for what's to come. There are 6 exercises in this warm-up. Each one is a minute long. I'm going to set my timer. The first exercise is basic enough. It's jog in place. I always just like to start a warm-up just by starting to move and get the heart rate up and get the blood flowing. The warm-up's a good time to get your mind ready, get mentally prepared for the rest of the workout as well. Just get everything moving, get the arms pumping, land softly on your feet. A good warm-up should just hit just about everything. Make you feel nice and loose and prepared. All right, the next exercise is alternating forward lunge. Just take turns lunging forward, one leg and then the other. Make sure that you lunge out far enough so that that forward knee stays behind the toes of the forward leg. And you can just let your arms hang at your sides or hold on to your hips. Use them for balance if you need to. Keep breathing, keep moving. Next, I've got a backstroke with a little bit of hip rotation. It's going to loosen up, warm up the shoulders, as well as your lower back and hips. Deep breathing. Next, we've got revolved alternating lunges. Take a lunge stance, turn towards your forward leg, open up your chest and shoulders. I like to use this arm to pull myself a little bit deeper into that stretch so I feel it in the hip flexors as well as the low back across the chest and shoulders. Alternate sides. Works on your balance a little bit as well. Feel a nice, good stretch on each side. Next is squat and expand. Slightly wider than shoulders width with your feet. Drop down into your squat. Expand and lift the chest towards your ceiling. Keep your heels firmly rooted to the ground while you squat. Exhale as you contract, inhale as you expand. Next is what I call balanced knees. Stand on one leg, extend your other leg back. You're gonna bend both knees at the same time and then extend both knees at the same time. And if you're too tight in your hamstrings to come all the way down to the floor, it's all right if you have some kind of chair or elevated surface to do this from to make it a little bit easier on yourself. Switch legs. Warm up, let's work out. Welcome to phase one dumbbell lower body. There are five exercises. I'm going to give a brief explanation of each exercise and then we'll get to work. First up is squats. Stand with your feet about hips width or shoulders width apart. Make sure that your feet are parallel with each other. Keep your heels firmly rooted to the ground. Bend your knees and stick your hips back. Come all the way up. Lower your thighs pretty low, maybe even up to parallel to the floor. Two things to keep in mind. If you're tight in the hips, you might notice that the heels want to come up off the floor or the knees might want to buckle. If either of those things start to happen to you, lessen your range of motion. So you would go less into your squat. Over time, as your hip flexibility and mobility increases, you'll be able to go deeper into this exercise. The next exercise is rear lunge. Standing with your feet about hips width apart, you're gonna hold two dumbbells at your sides, and you're just gonna step one leg back into a lunge. Step back far enough so that the front leg is at almost a 90-degree bend and step back up. You're going to stay with the same leg for the entire duration of the interval. You'll get the other leg the next time we come back around. Notice that I stay on the toes of the back foot. I don't plant the heel and turn the knee in an unhealthy direction. So the foot and the shin stay in a neutral alignment with the rest of the leg. The third exercise is the side lunge. So you're just going to lunge directly to the side. You're going to straddle your leg with the dumbbells and then explode back up to your starting position. So one thing to keep in mind as you're lunging to the side, you want to keep your lunging knee relatively behind your toes here. And you get that to happen by making sure that your hips scoot back in this lunge. So lunge up, keep the hips back, explode back up to standing. We'll work one side for the entire turn. We'll get the other side when we come back around to this exercise. The fourth exercise is called the calf raise. Stand with your feet hips width apart. Hold the dumbbells at your sides. Come up as high as you can onto your toes. Lower yourself back onto your heels. So a couple ways you can make this exercise harder or easier depending on where you need to go with it. You can either, of course, increase the weight But you can also increase the speed of which you do your calf raises. The last exercise of phase one dumbbell lower body workout is called a regressed deadlift. Regressed because we're going to start the deadlift from a standing position as opposed to picking the dumbbells or a barbell up off the floor. So, roll your shoulders back, stick your chest out. Slight micro bend in the knees so that the legs are not hyperextended. Stick your butt back and allow yourself to hinge forward from your hips. Notice in this position, my shoulders are still back, my chest is still out, my spine is nice and flat. I'm gonna come up, squeeze your belly, squeeze your glutes to the top, hinge back into this. So you only need to go as low as you can, as your hamstring flexibility allows, and as far as you can go without rounding out in the spine. If you start to lose this nice flat back, just come back up. Squeeze your belly, squeeze your glutes. This is a much safer variation of the deadlift for people who are just getting back into fitness or for anyone who is trying to just narrow in on their form a little bit more. All right, those are the five exercises of the phase one dumbbell lower body workout. Rule of thumb, if after the first interval goes through and you realize that maybe the weight that you are using was not heavy enough, or let's say that if you finished the interval and didn't feel like you absolutely had to put that weight down, then it's probably a good idea to go up in weight the next time through. Or opposite of that, if you couldn't make it through the entire interval with the weight that you chose, maybe you should drop down and wait for the next round. Let's get started. All right, we've gone over the five exercises. We're gonna go through those five exercises four times, so there are four rounds. The active work period of each exercise is 35 seconds long. The rest period between each exercise is just 15 seconds. So stay with me as best you can. It's totally fine if you need to go up or drop down weights in the middle of an exercise. Just try to keep track of where you're at and keep up. I've got my timer already set. Squats are first, grab your weights. I'm gonna start at 3, 2, let's go. Remember, hips width with the feet, keep your heels firmly rooted to the floor, drop into your squats. Inhale down, exhale up. Keep your knees tracking over your toes and keep your heels firmly rooted to the floor. Next up is our rear lunge. I'm gonna start with my left leg going back. I'm gonna get the right leg next time through. Step back into your lunge, step up. Step back far enough to keep that knee, that forward knee behind the toes of the forward foot. Set my dumbbells down just for a second. We've got the side lunge coming up. Again, I'm going with my left leg. Straddle the leg, explode up. Get the hips back. Exhale, power up. Calf raises are next. Up on your toes, back down to your heels. Shake out your hands for a moment if you get a chance. Regress deadlifts are next. Shoulders back, chest out. Feet hips width, slight bend in your knees. Stick your butt back, keep your back nice and flat. Squeeze your belly, squeeze your glutes at the top. Go ahead and keep your head in a neutral alignment with the rest of your spine. Round one is done. Starting back through squats. Rear lunge, this time I'm taking my right leg back. If you have any kind of knee problems, knee instability, knee soreness at home, and you still want to try to get this workout in, my suggestion is to lessen your range of motion. So try going not as deep in your lunges, maybe not as deep in your squats. As opposed to not doing any leg exercise at all. Side lunge. I'm lunging with my right leg. Sometimes people with knee problems find that the strength in those joints improve as they work them within the range of motion that's appropriate. And sometimes it strengthens all the surrounding muscles that really help out and assist the stability of that joint. Of course, if it's any kind of severe problem, have a doctor take a look at it. Calf raises. If you feel like you don't have much balance and you struggle with this exercise, try focusing your eyes on some unmoving point. Regress deadlifts. Shoulders back, chest out. Bend the knees slightly, stick your butt back. Hinge up. A great, phenomenal exercise for your hamstrings and your lower back. But it's also really good for your latissimus dorsi, the big muscles right in the middle of your back too. There's the halfway mark. We're back to squats. Rear lunge, it's my left leg that's going back again. And I usually try to turn and face the camera from different angles so you can kind of get a feel for what the form of the exercise looks like from all directions. Side lunge, left leg is the lunger. Back, explode up. Hitting the legs over and over again for each exercise like this really gets you tired. I'm wearing out. And it's a relatively fast paced resistance training workout. Calf raise. Last exercise of round three, regressed deadlift. Set yourself up, hips width, shoulders back, chest out, slightly bend the knees, stick your butt back. Squeeze your belly, squeeze your glutes. Last round, one more time for each of these exercises. We've got squats. My hands, my forearms, my grip, they're getting just as tired as my legs are here, holding onto these dumbbells. Rear lunge, my right leg is the lunging leg. Side lunge, the right leg for me is lunging. Get your hips back, straddle the leg, explode. Back up. Calf raise. Double times, burn them out. Last exercise, regress deadlifts. Pause it if you need to, grab a quick sip of water, and let's stretch. All right, so holding onto those dumbbells tired out my grips, tired out my forearms. So let's start there. Close your thumb into your palm, wrap your fingers around your thumb, big circles of the wrist. And switch directions. Release the thumbs, right palm up, pull the fingers back, straighten out the arm. Raise the wrist as high as your head. Release and shake it out. Left palm up, pull the fingers back, straighten out the arm. Deep breathing. Raise the wrist as high as your head. Release and shake it out. Step your feet wide. Parallel your feet. Root down into both feet. Draw your kneecaps up. Stretch from your inner groin down through your heels so that the legs are nice, firm, and stretching. Reach the arms up. Lengthen your spine. Decompress vertebrae. Extend. Reach. Swan dive. Wide leg forward fold. So keep the actions of the legs stretching from your groins down through your heels. Pulling the kneecaps up. Pushing down with the feet. Relax the muscles of your upper back. Let that release in the lower spine. Lift your chest away from your thighs. Lengthen your spine. Fold over so that the chest lowers above your left knee. Lift the chest, lengthen your spine, fold the chest over your right knee. Inhale, lift the chest. Step your right leg back so that you're in a low lunge. Sink your right hip flexor towards the floor, but keep the back of your right thigh up. Straighten your front leg, flex the toes back towards your face. Bend back into your front knee. Pivot to your right slightly so that the right leg stays straight and the left knee stays bent. Shift all the way to the other side. Pivot all the way around so that you're in a low lunge with the other leg forward. Sink your hip flexor, but keep the back thigh lifted. Straighten the front leg. Flex your toes back towards your face. Bend back into your front knee. Pivot all the way to the center. Straighten both legs. Fold in. Bend your knees. Roll up. Nice and easy. Step your legs together. Reach up. Stretch up. Lengthen. Big wide stretch. Thanks a lot. That's phase 1, dumbbell lower body. I'll see you soon.